my earlier days, we were often in the northern part of India because my father was in the bank. And very often we were in Orissa, in Assam and Madhya Pradesh and so many places. So right from my childhood, I had the opportunity of being in the wilderness for a long time. So that exposure had always kind of inspiration for me. When my father presented me with a box camera in 1962, I started photographing pictures of human beings. I used to process my own negatives and make contact prints in my bathroom at night. Then later on, until I reached the college, I changed a few cameras, slightly improved models. Soon after I came to Coimbatore, somebody told me there's a photographic club in Coimbatore. So I inquired about that and joined the photographic club. It was known as Coimbatore Photographic Society. It was a very old society, so I joined the club as a student member. Then, by knowing my interest and my quality of images, they immediately made me an executive committee member. Then, after a year or so, I was made honorary secretary of the Coimbatore Photographic Club. Then in 1971, I accidentally joined the bank, the very bank my father was working. Within 6 months, one of my friends who had an Asahi Pentax camera was about to sell, so I bought that camera. Since my childhood, I had a fascination for smaller subjects. So I started using this camera, but I experimented in many ways and found out that I had to extend the focal length of this normal 50mm lens so that I can get closer and take better pictures. So I decided to make the extension tubes locally through a friend of mine who had a lathe. I made an extension tube out of an aluminium block and painted it, and also made a lens reverse swing to reverse the lens to take closer pictures. Shot a lot of insects and wildflowers during the initial stage. Then after I had a sizable amount of images, then I started taking part in exhibitions.
Whenever there is talk about light, talk about color, talk about texture, Jairam will give wonderful. I don't think I've never heard anything like that in my life. Because he masters light. He knows light for more than half a century, very close. He can manipulate light now because digital. Early days, it was very difficult because the film has only one ISO. So many things were very difficult for him, but still, his lighting sense is amazing. It goes much above any meter. And another thing is, his lighting will give you a feel of a painting.
Nilgiris was one of my favorite place, and I found later many group of friends who took me and showed me many places. Mr. Ravi, Bonendra, Ravindra, Reggie, Joseph, Anandan, Chandru, Satyamurthy, then Rangasamy. These people took me in turns because they were also working, so they used to turn themselves to accompany me to some fields. So So that way I produced many interesting pieces from Nilgiris.
Nilgiris Photography and Nature Society, shortly known as NIPONS. And we also were members in another organization called Nilgiri Life, Wildlife and Environment Association. So these two associations had something in common, something to attract Mr. Jairam. So we decided we'll use this forum to pull him in here. So Photography Club, for the inauguration we called him. And he gladly came. And it was a great occasion. A lot of members could see a world level achiever. And he is a storehouse of knowledge and information. He's an encyclopedia. And the more you interact with him, the more you talk to him, slowly things will come out. So the Photography Club meeting was a success. And Mr. Jairam started falling in love with Nilgiris. Now, coming to Nilgiris is like coming to his second home. He always enjoys any opportunity, any friend calls him, he is willing to come with them. And he looks for pictures. So initially, he had selected insect photography because it was not something which everybody easily goes for. So achieving big in that was possible. So that is how we became world number two in insect photography. More than 40 years worth of friendship, which is just fantastic. I am sure I cannot find another person who will match his qualities personally, professionally, or otherwise. All round, he is just one of the best. I may have many friends, but he is right at the top.
You can still achieve by simple, constant daily work. That's what he was. He was a person who put in a systematic, quality work from morning, the time he got up, till the night. A day was scheduled so beautifully. We were terribly inspired. We were able to get a team of about 10-15 people always waiting and to receive and work with whatever Mr. Jairam is to say. So some of the memorable trips that we used to do is the visit to Mukurthi Peak. About 4-5 times we went to Mukurthi. In and around AI Mukurthi, a lot of photography was done. And then we went to Upper Bhavani in the Glenmorgan area and Sigur area, Masnagudi forests, the Moyar and Mudumalai forests. Many trips were made. Because Jairam is such a person, he will just not stop with taking a picture. He will take the picture and take it home. He will have a collection of about 400-500 pictures. He will sit down for 10 days without coming out, doing the taxonomy for the pictures. He will analyze the quality of the picture, segregate it, analyze the subject. The subject will be varying in minute ways and it will be a different species. All this he will find out. And he was able to find frogs in very camouflaged atmospheres, which we could never believe that a frog will be here, a frog will be there, it can be like this and all that. Sunrises, sunsets and all were beautiful moments which we never thought of in our hometown. He used to come and wait 4 o'clock in the morning, wait for the sunrise, wait for the right timing of this of the mist coming, the cloud coming, to catch the particular place with the particular natural settings. These kind of minute details which Jairam and I used to see and document makes him unique. For the first time, we started documenting where we became an authority of data on the Nilgiris. So we became responsible for the declaring the Mudumalai Wildlife Sanctuary as the National Tiger Sanctuary. Then the Elephant Corridor project was sanctioned, which was the only one of its kind in India.
Management of Mudumalai Tiger Reserve invited Mr. K. Jairam to shoot the prestigious Mudumalai Tiger Reserve and the Mukuthi National Park. So I was fortunate to be an assistant as we went to the Mukuthi National Park's Bangidabal area, where we shot some excellent pictures of the virgin grasslands of Western Ghats. So as we were there at a place called Meyer Falls, where you have a tower called the CM Watch Tower, Jairam came in the morning around 6:20 and started to shoot. In that one small little space, he took around a variety of 24 different pictures. All the 24 pictures were of world class. Minimum of equipment and the maximum of his mind was applied in that. Mr. Jairam is giving a lesson through his pictures, how beautiful this world is and how should we conserve this. I fondly remember one backlighting picture of Mahonia leaf, which he photographed in backlighting. None would expect to see the subject. It is always how you see the subject. Right sitting in his house, in his balcony, he has taken a wonderful picture of full moon. He converted that picture in black and white, with clouds, with such beautiful details, and the post-production was wonderful. The world has to see these kind of pictures of Mr. Jairam, how he has mastered landscape photography, where he has taken Alps Mountain, right at the top of the Alps Mountain, making sure that Alps crow were in the frame. Normally, if you say Malambala Dam, it is on water. But he has taken a picture, a dam without water. It was so dry, but it had full of grass. Sheep was grazing. Patch of light just flashing in between those herd of cattle which was grazing. Once you see that, the beauty of this world through Mr. Jairam's eye, you fall in love with nature. The other thing is, you'll stop destruction and you'll become conservationist. The spread of this chain from Mr. Jairam, if it goes everywhere, I think so, this world will become beautiful once again.
I think no other photographers, they just take pictures. We all take pictures, but we don't know how to explain that, or we don't know what is the subject in taking that picture. So he knows that. For instance, there was a small chick which had a small marking in its mouth. And he explains, why is this small mark here? When the mother bird flies at that high speed, and it has to exactly come to that mouth and feed that bird, in that fraction of timing, it has to do that. So in nature, it has given that markings. So you would have not known unless and until he explains that. So he has gone in depth to study that, what is that marking and why it has come. we happened to do a book for Karnataka government on Kabini. So the editor was, he also knew him through so many books that he has published. So he wants particularly Jairam's picture to be used in that book. So he asked me whether, since you know him, can you ask him to support us in that? Without any hesitant, he said, I can do it, there's no problem. And not only he gave the picture, he helped in the layout also. At that time only we know, even though he was only, we thought he is just a photographer, but no, he was also an editor, how to edit, what was the word to be kept there. So all that he explained to us.
Till from 1975 to 2010, probably more than 400 to 500 books have published my pictures. British Museum and very well-known international encyclopedias, publications, magazines, they all published my pictures. So I learned many techniques of about the taxonomy, botany, entomology, zoology, natural history and biology and all that. And also, I have had the opportunity of traveling with such scientists, wherein I could learn their latest techniques and ideas. So that way also my photography improved. Apart from photography, I became fairly a good botanist or entomologist or a taxonomist, or whatever you call. So I was able to give lectures in schools and colleges and universities on various topics from nature. Also, I have had the opportunity of editing and publishing many books on nature. Especially the first book came out was Some South Indian Butterflies in association with the Nilgiri Wildlife Association. And this field guide book was edited by Dr. Gunathilak Raj, and I did the taxonomy work. I also had opportunity of working on the book on Silent Valley and also on jungle lodges from Karnataka.
கிட்டத்தட்ட 25 வருஷத்துக்கு மேல அவர் கூடவே சுத்தி இருக்கிறேன். இங்கே வந்து நீலகிரியை பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா பங்கித்தப்பால், கேன் ஹில், அப்புறம் தொட்டபெட்டால டைகர் ஹில், இந்த சைட்லலாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா மழை காலத்தில் ஃப்ராகை பற்றி ஃபோட்டோகிராஃப் பண்ணுறதுக்காக போவோம். அந்த ஃப்ராக் ஃபோட்டோகிராஃப் பண்ணும்போது பார்த்திங்கன்னா அவர் ஃபஸ்ட்டு ஷூட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு முன்னாடி அதை டீட்டெயில்ஸ் எல்லாமே கரெக்டாக இருக்கான்னு நீங்களும் பாருங்கள் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி கொடுப்பாரு. அது வந்து நிறைய பேர் என்னென்ன கிளிக் பண்ணிடுவாங்க. அதுக்கப்புறம் இவர் பார்க்கும்போது அந்த டீட்டெயில்ஸ் பார்த்திங்கன்னா என்னென்ன வேணுமோ அவ்வளோ டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷனும் அதில் இருக்கும், ஒவ்வொரு பிக்சர்லேயும் இருக்கும், ரொம்ப துல்லியமாக இருக்கும். ஒரு குகை, அந்த குகையில் தான் நாங்கள் தங்கணும். நைட்டு சாப்பாடு இல்லை, ஒன்றும் இல்லை, எல்லாம் இது பண்ணிகிட்ருக்கோம். பிஜு வந்து என்ன பண்ணுறாரு, அப்போ தான் ஃபுட்டு ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணுறாரு. கஞ்சி வெல்லம் பயிர், அதுவே பெரிய இது. காட்டுக்குள்ளார இந்த மாதிரி பண்ணுறது வந்து பெரிய பெரிய கிஃப்ட். அதில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அந்த குகைக்குள்ளார மூணு பேர் தான் படுக்க முடியும். நான், அவர், ஜெயராம் சார், மூணு பேரும் வந்து முன்னாடி ஸ்னஃப் பவுடரை போட்டுட்டு உள்ளுக்குள்ளார நாங்கள் படுத்துணும். நைட் ஃபுல்லாக தூக்கம் வராது, மழை கொட்டுது. அந்த அருவி ஃபால்ஸ் வந்து ரொம்ப சூப்பராக இருக்கும். இந்த பேர்ட்ஸு, பட்டர்ஃப்ளை, இந்த ஃப்ராக்ஸ் எல்லாம் இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு சூழலில் அங்கே இருக்குது. அன்டிஸ்டர்ப்டாக இருக்கிறதுனால தான் அதெல்லாம் இருக்குது. அதனால தான் இவங்க போய் நியூ ஃப்ராக்ஸ் எல்லாம் வந்து கண்டுபிடிக்கிறாங்க, அதை ஃபோட்டோகிராஃப் பண்ணுறாங்க, வெளிக்கொண்டுறாங்க, அதெல்லாம் ப்ரிசர்வ் பண்ணணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு. அதோட இன்ட்ரென்சிக் வேல்யூ வந்து யாருக்குமே தெரியாது. அதை வந்து கொண்டு வந்தவர் வந்து நம்ம ஜெயராம் சார் தான். மெயின்லி பட்டர்ஃப்ளை, பேர்ட்ஸ், அதே மாதிரி ஃப்ராக், இவ்வளவும் வெளியே கொண்டு வந்திருக்காரு. அதாவது இன் டெப்த்து, எதாக இருந்தாலும் எந்த சப்ஜெக்டாக இருந்தாலும் இன் டெப்த் போவார், சும்மா மேலோட்டமாக போகிறதே கிடையாது.
தி டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் மீ அண்ட் அதர்ஸ் இன் டீலிங் வித் ஜெயராம் இஸ் வெரி சிம்பிள். ஐ கன்சிடர் ஜெயராம் போத் ஆஸ் எ சூப்பர்லேட்டிவ் பெர்ஃபார்மர் ஆஸ் வெல் அஸ் எ ஹியூமன் பீயிங். Whereas all others have put him in a pedestal, unable to talk freely with him. since that I consider him as a fellow human being, he became very close to me. You may not believe that faunal work in India started in the year 1881 and ended in 1932 when the British left. Only Porifera remains to be updated. Those volumes, Jayaram, about 47 volumes, Jayaram had reprinted editions at a considerable cost, more than 2 lakhs, all those volumes. And the important part of which is, even the scientists are not able to leaf through the book because of the combination of Latin and Greek with English. But Jayaram used to leaf through all the pages and get the specimen correctly identified. To get it confirmed only, he used to come to me. Then I took him to Kerala Forest Research Institute and several other places. People were spellbound after the lecture by Jayaram. Even they didn't disperse for the lunch. Through him only, we came to know the more about the animal world. For example, when we camped in Chitteri Forest Guest House, we went for a walk during the evening. There was a small tank, maybe pond. So he said, if there is a small pond in a grassy area, we can expect a tiger. So let us sit. Most of our group people are afraid of Delhi, I mean tiger. But yet we waited. Just as he pronounced, deers came first, followed by elephants, and then majestic tiger came. So this is how we came to know of nature also only through Jayaram. He has the practical knowledge in his fingertips.
ஒரு பட்டர்ஃப்ளைக்கு ஒரே இடத்துல ஒரு 4 மணி நேரம் 5 மணி நேரம் இருந்து அது கரெக்டான ஒரு ஃப்ரேம் வர வரைக்கும் வெயிட் பண்ணி அது ஃபோட்டோ எடுக்கிறதுன்னு ஒரு பயங்கர த்ரில்லிங். ஒரு பட்டர்ஃப்ளை எடுக்கிறதுக்கு இவ்வளோ டைம் ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்ணுமா அப்படின்ற மாதிரி ஒரு எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் அது. அதே போல் அண்ணா ஃப்ரேம்ஸ் எல்லாம் வேஸ்ட் பண்ண மாட்டார். அண்ணாக்கு ஒரு சப்ஜெக்ட் அது வந்து பர்ஃபெக்டாக இருக்குது, அதை எடுத்தால் நல்லா வரும் அப்படின்ட்டு அவர் மனசு பட்டால் மட்டும்தான் அதை எடுப்பார். பக்கத்தில் டைகரே போனாலும் அது அதை டைகரை போடுற பொண்ணு அந்த மாதிரி எல்லாம் இல்லை. என்ன சப்ஜெக்ட் அண்ணாக்கு வேணும் அது பர்ஃபெக்டாக அது கிடைக்கும் அந்த மாதிரி இருந்தால் மட்டும் அண்ணா வந்து அதை ஃபோட்டோகிராஃப் பண்ணுவார்.
இது வந்து ஜெயராம் சார் கூட நான் பயணப்பட்ட அவலாஞ்சி ஊட்டி எல்லாம் பார்த்தா திடீர்னு ஒரு இடத்துல நிறுத்த சொல்லுவார். அப்புறம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அங்கே இறங்கி போய் ஒரு படம் எடுப்பார். அது ஒரு 10 அடி 20 அடி 30 அடி அல்லது 1 கிலோமீட்டர் உள்ளே நடந்து போய் எடுப்பார். அது எனக்கு இன்னமும் ஒரு மௌனமான மொழியில் மரம் செடி கொடி பூச்சி இதுக்கு எல்லாமே பேசுகிற கலை ஒன்று இருக்கு போல தான் தெரியுது இவர் ஃபோட்டோ பார்த்தா. அப்போ ஒவ்வொரு ஃபோட்டோக்கு பின்னாலேயும் ஒரு கதை இருக்கும். நாம் ஃபோட்டோவோடு கடக்கிறோம், அதுலேயும் இந்த மாதிரி கலைஞனுடைய ஒவ்வொரு போட்டோக்கு பின்னால் இருக்கிற கதைகள் வந்து பதிவு செய்யப்பட்டால் இன்னும் நல்லா இருக்கும்னு எனக்கு தோணும்.
இந்த நூலகத்தில் அமர்ந்திருக்கிற நேரத்துலலாம் சின்ன சின்ன குழந்தை வாசகர்கள் வரும்போது அவர்களுக்கு சில புத்தகங்களை இவர் விரும்பி சஜஸ்ட் பண்ணுவார். அதில் ஒரு முக்கியமான புத்தகம் சேசிங் த மான்சூன். மழைக்கால மேகங்களை துரத்தி கொண்டு ஒரு மனிதன் ட்ராவல் செய்வான். அது எவ்வளோ அருமையான புகைப்படக்கலை சார்ந்த தகவல்கள் நிறைந்த புத்தகங்கிறத அந்த குழந்தைக்கு உணர வைப்பார். இவருடைய அணுகுமுறையினால் அந்த குழந்தை அதை புத்தகத்தை எடுத்துகிட்டு போய் படிச்சுட்டு, அங்கிள் இவ்வளோ பெரிய வேர்ல்டுக்குள்ளே என்னை ட்ராவல் பண்ண வச்சுருக்கீங்கன்னு வந்து சிரிச்சுக்கிட்டு அடுத்த முறை சொல்லும்போது அது ஒரு இனிமையான அனுபவம்.
A nature photographer like Jayaraman contributes to conservation and wildlife studies, in addition to being a remarkable photographer. I have known him for the last 30 years, and his commitment to work amazes me, because he just doesn't accept the subject as they are. What he does, he studies them, understands their behavior, and then photographs. In the process, he becomes an expert of the creatures that he is studying. That's what he has become now. In the early days, he was concentrating mainly on insects and butterflies, what is often known as microphotography, which is very difficult. You work with limited light and very limited depth of field. You know, I'm talking about pre-digital days. But in those days, when getting equipment itself was very difficult, films were expensive, and very often the films were not developed in India. You had to send them abroad. Lenses were not available, but with all that, he managed to keep up his work and produced very impressive photographs. Because he studied them so closely, he was able to identify them. So he became a good taxonomist. So much so that two of the creatures that were discovered in the Western Ghats have been named after him, a spider and a frog. So what a nature photographer does, and what Jayaraman does in his work, is to record the creatures in their habitat, and also often record their behavior, which is hitherto unknown to science.
As I was studying photography, I was also studying nature. So I started studying animal behavior. I read a lot of books like M. Krishnan and all those great Jim Corbett and so many writers. So I had some kind of intuition with animals and birds. So that way I know how an animal is going to behave in a particular time. Then I always used to interact with specialists. So I used to hear stories from them, get the knowledge I can store in my brain. So I could use all these things, their experiences and knowledge, which I try to apply in the field. But I don't think I have failed with animals anyway. Quite confident and comfortable with wild animals.
He's an artist, also a scientist. He's such an exponent, and he's the youngest international macro photographer. When he was young, he sent to international competitions, and he won plenty of awards. He was a master in black and white photography. He used to have his own lab, he used to have his own mix his chemicals and print his pictures. Great opportunity of traveling with him for several years. We used to go to many places throughout India. We have been to Gir Forest, we have been to Gujarat, Thol Lake, and we have been to Bharatpur, and many such places we have traveled together. And he has done plenty of work for Kerala Forest Department. Especially his work is very much appreciated for the work he has done for Silent Valley Project. He's a very meticulous person. Basically, he's a very disciplined and meticulous person and voracious reader. His library is worth seeing. He has so many books and so many pictures. Even one day is not enough. You have to spend several days with him to see all his work. Done a lot of printing for him. I have a good printer, printed some pictures in Bangalore and Chennai. It was not up to his satisfaction. Then I specially bought a printer and for myself and Jayaram. We learned how to print. We calibrated our machines properly to the international standard, and we imported papers also, art boards and art, art material, and we printed on them. It looks almost like painting. So we used to import canvas from German, we used to print on German papers. We calibrate our system and the printer as well as the medium, that is the canvas, or we sync all the three and go for the printing. The colors what you see on monitor you will get in the print also. When Jayaram started, it was still more backstage. There was no material available to even to read. So it all, one has to experiment, learn from mistakes. You have to do mistakes and learn from the mistakes. Either he used to gather things and he learned by himself. It was a very Himalayan task, learning those photography those days. And that too, winning a competition internationally is something remarkable. That he could do that because of his strong passion and dedication. Only because of that he could attain that. And he has won almost all the awards. Very coveted titles he has got. But never show it off to anyone. That is the, he's not a self-propaganda person. He confines himself and he enjoys photography rather than advertising his talents.
So while traveling, as I used to shoot landscapes, I found landscapes were also being destroyed. For widening the roads, many beautiful trees were, centuries old trees were cut. There were mobile towers and windmills and power lines. These were ugly scenes in a landscape. So I had to travel, look for very remote landscapes without any human touch in that. So I traveled wildly throughout India in producing wild landscape pictures. Just like a painting is produced, a photograph should also be produced, should not be taken. You can take pictures with mobile phone, but if you are using a good camera, you will have to produce a picture. The producing a picture is both an art and science. You'll have to visualize how the final image is going to come, how to compose, wait for the proper lighting conditions, weather conditions, then composition. All these ingredients put together only makes a good photograph. So you'll have to conceive that idea and try to bring out till the end. You'll have to apply all kinds of techniques and ideas to make the picture come out successfully. We'll be right back. get the inspiration from music, literature, poetry. Many great painters like Rembrandt and some German painters who painted landscapes in America. I have a many large collection of those books. So some of these paintings gives you a lot of idea about how light and shade and color and contrast, brightness and luminosity and composition is maintained in each painting. Gives a lot of inspiration for making good photographs. So to shoot birds, you'll have to go to very far off places, and especially, and also if you want to shoot wild animals, you'll have to visit sanctuaries. In the process of my long journey traveling here and there, I found since these subjects are coming down, I thought the landscape is also getting distorted. And also I produced 50 archival quality prints, and I made a one-man show in Coimbatore and in Calicut in Kerala. Although my exhibition was on display for more than a month, hardly some 20 people visited in Coimbatore. But whereas in Kerala for 2 days, nearly 2,000 people visited the exhibition, and some of my exhibits were also bought by collectors. So that way I was happy that I could produce some archival prints. I traveled in Kerala. I came in contact with Mr. P.K. Uthaman, a well-known bird photographer at that time. Then Namasivayan, who was a bird man and a conservationist. Sivaprasad, Manoj, N.P. Jain. These friends from Kerala, they helped me a lot in showing me different places in Kerala, throughout Kerala. And many of the Kerala forest officials did a great help in help for me, and they gave me permission, and they gave me all facilities to make good pictures. During the 70s, 80s and 90s, I spent a lot of time with His Highness Maharaja from Madhya Pradesh, Shri B.N.S. Dio and his son R. Dev, along with Mr. T.N. Nipirmal. We had a wonderful time traveling together and discussing more about the future of photography, all our trips. Also, I spent a lot of time with Shri S.G. Neginhal, the retired forest official, and with Mr. T.N. Nipirmal, his son Jai Kumar, and D. Srinivasan and Karthik from Coimbatore. Together we traveled to many places, especially towards the northern Karnataka states, and visited many sanctuaries. Srimati Shanti and Venkatramanan, a unique couple who had accompanied us in many field trips, especially with Dr. Biju during our amphibian research. My brothers and sisters, especially my loving mother, was a great help and enthusiastic, kept monitoring of all the flora and fauna happening in our campus, and she used to report me every day whatever she had seen. So that way I could record some of the flora and fauna, insects and other subjects, that whatever came to my house. Mother was a really a resourceful person. Finally, I am thankful to Mayan and Sugandhan of Mayan's Theatre for making this exhaustive documentary possible.
We had the chance to look through the viewfinder. As soon as he finishes taking a picture, he will keep the camera on the tripod for others to watch. So that was something unbelievable. And anybody nearby can also watch. Mesmerizing their colors, their sometimes the backlighting is so beautiful. The imagery, how he composes his imagery, is something still cannot be explained by words. It can be seen, it has to be seen.
I've been associated with these gentlemen for almost maybe 2 to 3 decades. And each one of them has played a great role in my success. They have shown me many great places because all these friends, they trek, their hobbies trekking, and they know these all these remote places, beautiful places in Nilgiris. So they have taken me to all the remote corners of Nilgiris and helped me take better pictures and record the flora and fauna of Nilgiris, especially Nilgiris.
Jayaram is a versatile photographer, and he uses the intricacies of natural sunlight falling on the subject. Even a roadside view of blades of grass will speak action-packed episode through his lens. I was amazed to see his patience and meticulous handling of his camera. Jayaram has the knack of using his camera to dance to his tunes. I wish him a very long life and for more and more contributions to the scientific world.
Sir, it's been an amazing journey with you in making this film. It is very inspiring, big learning for us in associating with you to finish this film. We thank you, your family, and all friends who made this film possible for us, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
It's my pleasure, and I'll definitely try to cooperate with you in your future.
Yes, sir. So much to mentor
thank
more,
you.
Sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
This is a wool spider carrying hundreds of eggs packed in a sack and holding it with two claspers at the end of the abdomen. This is a rare picture. This I shot in 1978. This is a jewel beetle. It's at the egg site. This had, like, she had laid a cluster of eggs. This is a fairly 2 to 3 inch long jewel beetle. This picture had also been exhibited in many Indian exhibitions. This is a female scorpion carrying her young ones on her back. And you can see when she is carrying her young ones, you can see that her fang gland and the fang tip is so sharp and sterile that it is highly carrying potent venom in the venom sac to protect her young ones. this picture had also won many awards. This is a very small, just quarter of an inch size bug, just leaving the brood. And scientifically, if you can see, these egg clusters have been hatched open. So each egg has got a small perforations here through which the egg hatches. It's just like tearing a paper from a letter pad where you have the perforations. So the perforation markings you can clearly see here. You can see those perforation markings on each egg. So this picture was taken with a spectacle lens fitted on the front of a 50mm normal lens with which I took this picture. This picture had won many both the international and Indian exhibition awards. These are known as archival prints. It's been printed with the inkjet print. 11 ink cartridges have been used to make this print. This paper is imported from Germany. And these are some of the landscape pictures, archival print. If maintained properly, these prints can last for 100 years. This picture I took while editing the Jungle Lodges book in Kabini in Karnataka. This picture is taken on a misty morning. This picture had won recently, about 4 or 5 years back, international award in the Smithsonian photo contest. This is a scientifically very important picture. You can see these are bugs. They have killed a beetle. Beetles normally have a very hard shell, and it's very difficult to kill the beetle because they are, especially the tortoise beetles, have a very curved surface that even the birds cannot pick them up. This is an epiphytic impatiens orchid wildflower from Silent Valley. This picture was taken in backlighting. This flower was on about 10 feet on a tree. 20, 30 years or more than that, I would have probably shot more than 3.5 lakh transparencies. From insects to infinity, it's been a very long journey over 5 decades for me, from micro to macro and from primitive film camera to the advanced digital gadgets today. I have been both a witness and a player through the evolution of photography and technology. My passion and obsession ran parallel in search of science and art with a camera in this wonderland, chasing life and light. Now, I strive to capture artistic, moody landscapes, which drives me on a wild adventure into the sublime nature. Still, very thrilled to search and capture my elusive masterpiece of a picture. It goes on and on and on.